All right, now let's go back there and see what it's all about. Hi. Jay and I just, well, we spotted something down here. We went up to get a paper first, but then we saw an O. Yeah, an O, letter O. And we have an idea, so come on over here. Now, there it is. There's the letter O, and we all know who lives here, right? And there's an O on the outside, so let's speak to him. Oscar?
What do you want?
Oscar, Jay and I just saw...
Hi, Jay.
Boy, you're polite. You really are. You said, say that again.
I don't want to.
That's better. It's more like Oscar. Because we saw an O in the front of your...
Oscar.
She's just contrite. It's a C word. We saw an O in the front of your can. And we know that it's the first letter in your name, so we know why it's here.
Boy, you really think you know it, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes you really amaze me, Gordon.
Mm-hmm. Sure, yeah. See, it's the first letter in Oscar, so you put it on the front of your can so that everybody would know where you lived.
Sometimes you really amaze me with how wrong you can be.
You mean that's not why it's there? It's not for O in Oscar so everybody would know where you live?
You catch on quick.
Oh. Oh, I know. Open. You see, you put an O on the front of your trash can because O is the first letter in open, and for anybody to get into your trash can, they have to open the lid. Open.
Gordon, sometimes you really do amaze me.
Wrong again, huh?
Wrong again.
Only. You see, you are the only person on Sesame Street who lives in a trash can. Therefore, O. Being the first letter in only, that's why it's here. Oh.
Ding dong, you're wrong. You'll never get it.
Ding dong, you're wrong. Well, come on, Oscar. Tell me why it's here. Why is it there?
Okay. The O is to remind everyone to keep away from me and leave me alone.
I don't understand that, Jay. Now, why would the letter O mean for everybody to get away from you and leave you alone?
Well, if you'll just unroll this paper. See that paper? It's all rolled up.
Oh, yeah.
Now, unroll that and read it, and you'll see.
Oh, wait a minute. O is for over. Okay. Over and over and over, I have asked you not to bother me and to stay far away from me like you are right now. Well, I guess that O served its purpose. I'm sure far enough away from you. I get the message.
Well, I'm glad about that. Goodbye.
Oh.
Grow and go, roll over the road where the goat explodes all the O's and the crow flies low. Past the croaking toad and the boat floats over the ocean, but the wind did blow and it started to snow. So the toad went home to the telephone. He spoke to the goat who was eating a bowl of bones, potatoes and soap. A rope did float and hooked the goat, and the boy climbed the stone made of O's. The O's turned to smoke and started to float closer to the bulldozer, who closed up the hole so the cold wind could not blow, and the sun did show so the roses could grow, and the whole world would know that the boat bulldozer, the toad and the crow, the boy and the rope, riding the goat, were all okay. Okay?
Oh. Open. Oh. Open. Open. Oh.
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah.
7 spooky spiders.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 nickels.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 pumpkin pies. Oh.
Oh, hi. Hey, I was just about to ask Jay a few questions about, well, some of these pieces of silverware that I have in my hand here. See if you know some of the answers also, okay? Now, Jay, if I was going to spread a little peanut butter on the tip of your nose, now, if I was going to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, what would I use here? Would I use the spoon or the fork?
No, you'd use the knife.
You'd use the knife, right. If you want to spread some peanut butter on a sandwich, you should use a knife. Right. Okay, now, let's see. For dessert, I'm going to have some cake, okay?
Okay.
You like cake?
Yeah.
All right. What do we use to eat our cake? Should we use the knife?
No, you should use your fork.
Use your fork. Right. If you want to eat a piece of cake, you should use your fork. That works best of all, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let's see. What's another one? First thing in the morning, I'm going to have some cereal, right?
Yeah.
All right. What do we put the sugar on the cereal with? The knife or the fork?
You can use any spoon.
You can use any spoon. You can use this big soup spoon or tablespoon, or you can use this small spoon, which is a teaspoon, right?
Yeah.
Either of those two spoons will work. Hey, very good. How are you doing? Okay, now let's see. For lunch, I think I'll have a sandwich for lunch, okay? Eat that peanut butter and sandwich that we made earlier there. Now, what will we cut the sandwich with? A fork or a spoon or a knife or the little spoon?
A knife.
Should cut the sandwich with a knife, right? Sure. Okay, now with my sandwich, I think I'll have a little soup, okay? What'll we drink our soup with? Fork, knife, spoon, spoon.
You can use the tablespoon.
You can use the tablespoon, this big spoon here, right? Or you could use
the teaspoon.
The little teaspoon, right? You could drink soup with either of those two spoons. Hey, you know, it'd be pretty difficult, wouldn't it, to try and drink soup with a fork, huh?
Hey, buddy, it's time for lunch. Come and get it.
Mm-hmm. Boy, I sure am hungry today, Jim.
Me too.
What's for lunch, Jim?
Today for lunch, buddy, we have good hot soup.
Mm-hmm. Boy, that smells good enough to be soup, Jim.
Okay. Now, what do you want, buddy? A spoon or a fork?
I think I'll take a fork.
Okay, buddy has the fork, and Jimmy has the spoon. And now we'll have our soup.
I sure am hungry.
Oh, me too. Mmm, that's good soup.
Hey, Jim. Your soup good?
Oh, it sure is. Best soup I ever tasted.
Something wrong with my soup.
What do you mean there's something wrong with your soup? That's your favorite soup. It's chicken soup.
Doesn't have much taste.
Doesn't have much taste.
Nope, not much taste to my soup.
Let me have a taste of that, and I'll tell you if it has any taste or not.
Well, I can tell you already, I tasted it. It doesn't have much taste, Jim. See?
Buddy,
what
are you talking about? That soup is delicious.
This soup is delicious?
Of course it is. Now, eat your lunch. Come on.
Mm. Smells delicious.
Of course, because it is delicious.
Something wrong with my soup, Jim. It doesn't have much taste at all.
Buddy, hold everything. Your soup and my soup came out of the same pot, right?
Yeah, I saw you dip it out.
Of course I did. Now, my soup is good. That means that your soup has to be good.
That means my soup has to be good.
Of course it is. Now, eat your soup.
Boy, I hope it's good.
Mmm, it's Good soup.
Jim.
What is it now?
Something's wrong with my soup. And you say your soup is good?
It sure is.
They both came out of the same pot, right?
Same pot.
The only difference is you're using a spoon and I'm using a fork. Maybe there's something wrong with my fork.
Hold everything.
What is it, Jim?
Your soup and my soup came out of the same pot, right?
That's right.
Buddy?
What?
I think there's something wrong with your fork.
Wow. You sure are smart, Jim.
Of course I'm smart. That's very simple. We'll just get rid of the old fork.
Yeah, but what we do
now?
And
we'll get you a new fork.
Boy, you sure do take care of me, don't you, Jim?
That's because you're my best friend.
Thanks, Jim.
And I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
What's that?
To make sure your soup is good,
yeah?
I'm going to give you my bowl, and you give me your bowl.
Boy, thanks a million, Jim.
You're welcome. You have my bowl, and I have Buddy's bowl.
You really do take care of Buddy, don't you, Jim?
Of course I do. Now eat your soup.
Sure, I'm hungry now.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Is soup good, Jim?
Oh, it's the best soup I ever tasted.
You sure do take care of Buddy. Maybe I'll make myself a nice peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Hey, say hello to Gretel. We have Gretel visiting us on Sesame Street here today. Did you say hello to Gretel yet, boys?
Oh, hello, Gretel.
Hello, Gretel.
Hello.
Do you know what kind of an animal this is? It starts with a W. Or it could start with a G.
A woodchucker?
A woodchuck, right? Mm-hmm. Or a groundhog. You can call them either woodchucks or groundhogs. Isn't that a beautiful animal?
Mm-hmm.
It's nice, beautiful fur. Nice, hairy. He's pretty quiet right now, isn't he?
Yes.
It's kind of like, sort of like when he hibernates. Do you know what the word hibernates mean?
Mm-hmm.
Hibernate?
Sleep?
Sleeps, right.
Oh.
Can you think of another animal that sleeps during the wintertime?
A bear.
Oh. Right. And you know what they do? They eat a lot of food, and then they go into their cave or down into their little hole, and they sleep most of the wintertime.
Uh-huh.
Would you like to hibernate?
No.
Would you, Tracy? He wouldn't like to hibernate either. He's nice and quiet like that. Hey, who knows what Groundhog Day is? You ever heard of Groundhog Day?
Yeah, I've heard of it.
Have you? Huh? You ever heard of Groundhog Day?
No.
Well, that's on February 2nd. That's Groundhog Day. And a lot of people think that if a groundhog comes out of his hole, they live in little holes in the forest and places like that. If they come out and they see their shadow, then we're going to have 6 more weeks of winter weather. 6 more weeks.
A superstition?
Yeah. Well, it's sort of a superstition, but it's kind of fun.
Oh.
But they live in these little holes. You know, certain animals live only in certain places, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, would you find an animal like this at the North Pole, do you think?
No.
No, why not? Because
it's
too cold, right. And you wouldn't find one in the middle of the desert either, because it's too hot there. But you might find one if you took a trip through the woods.
One day, David and Jill went on a picnic with their mommy and daddy. They had never been in the woods before, so they decided to take a little walk and see what they could see.
Look what I caught!
A spider! Is he dead?
No.
No.
Sir John.
No.
got away.
Are there any in?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, it's right there. Ma'am?
They walked a little further and came to a stream.
There's a fish!
It's coming! David! The fish! He's gone.
What is that thing in the water?
And he's a frog.
I want to try to catch mine again. I got him again.
But
now I'm going to go show.
They thought the way the frog jumped around was funny, so they tried doing it themselves. As they were jumping along, they saw one of these. Do you know what it is?
A turtle. A very tiny turtle. Four legs.
A shell.
He found his shell, right?
I wonder how he got it on.
He had it on.
Maybe he found it.
Then they stopped to pick some berries, very small berries that look like tiny little apples. Here are some of the other things they saw. They went back and told about the things they saw. Can you name some of them? A spider, a leaf, a fish, a frog, a turtle. If you go to the woods, see if you can find what David and Jill saw.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4,
no!
3, 2, 1.
Oh, boy.
Hey, what you doing there,
wow.
Bert?
Oh, boy, Ernie, I got this terrible itch here right in the place of my back that I can't scratch, you know? It's driving me bananas. Oh.
I know how you feel there, Bert. Nothing worse than having an itch where you can't reach it. Hooey! You know, just thinking about it makes me itchy. I got an itch on my bicycle I can't reach, too.
Oh, yeah? Oh, boy. That's terrible. Hey, Ernie. Hey, hold it. Hey, you know what? I got an idea.
What's that?
See, I got an itch that I can't reach, and you got an itch that you can't reach. So how's about we trade?
You mean you take my itch and I'll take yours?
Right. No.
Look,
you see, you scratch my back where it itches,
yes?
And then I'll do the same for you, okay?
Oh, what a great idea, Bert.
Yeah.
I can reach your back, you can reach my back.
Right.
Hey, turn around,
okay.
And I'll scratch your back.
Oh, that's great.
There you go. Okay, now you do
good.
Mine.
Okay.
Okay, a little bit lower there, Bert. A little bit lower.
Okay.
And over now.
Right.
Over towards the shoulder.
Right.
Okay, and now down a little bit. Down a little bit from where you were.
All right.
Woo, that feels good. Oh, that's great, Bert.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, everybody ought to do this. Matter of fact, everybody, scratch.
Thank you.
town. Okay, keep going, Bert.
Okay, I'm going.
Over to the left.
Oh, yeah.
Boy, that's great.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Bert, you're a very good scratcher. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I was just,
Me.
Wait a minute.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
What's happening, man?
I don't know.
What's that?
I don't know.
Looks like a fishhook.
It's not a fishhook. It's a J.
A what?
The letter J. Like to hear a story about the letter J, boys?
Yes.
Once upon a time, a guy named Joe noticed a June bug on his toe. Put it in a jar and started to go. But here come the judge and said, no, no, no. So Joe said why and started to jump and dance a jig on an old tree stump. Then jogged along to the city dump where he jammed the June bug in a tire pump. Then the judge caught up and started to wail and said to Joe, justice will prevail. Then the jury met and set the bail and Joe got an hour in the city jail.
So that's the letter J.
It still looks like a fish hook.
You know what else we learned?
Yeah, don't drive a jet by jamming a June bug.
Can you guys think of a kind of a boat that begins with the letter J? That's a tricky one. Hmm?
I don't know.
Really? Junk.
Oh, yeah, Chinese junk.
That's right, yeah. Got a couple of junky boats right here, don't you? Look at those.
Yeah.
Okay, now that one's yours, Jay.
Yep.
And what's the name of it?
It's 346.
The 346?
Yep.
What's the name of yours?
The Emily.
The Emily. Okay. Tell you what now. We're going to have a race. The race is like this. Jay, your boat has to get over to Ford's side before Ford's boat gets over to your side and vice versa, right?
Okay.
Okay. Now, I'm going to count to 10. And as soon as I get... What was that, man?
I took my breath.
Oh, you were getting your breath. All right. You sure you got it? I'm going to count to 10. Ready? And as soon as I get to 10, then you're going to blow, right? And when you blow, stop holding your breath. Hold your breath. As soon as I get to 10, then you're going to blow.
Okay.
And when you blow on the sail, right,
yeah,
of the boat. Right? And that'll make the sail move, and that'll move the boat, and it'll go across, just like sailboats work, right?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What's blowing? Wait a minute. Oh, you not only beat Jay Ford, you also sank his boat. That was pretty good. You want to try it again?
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
You sure? Okay, come on. Set him up. Set him up. Ready? Okay, this time I'll just count to 3. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Jay blew your own boat away. That's what real, come here, Ford. That's what real sailboats, that's what happens to sailboats. They have real wind, you know? Can you think of any other time when wind is blown or air is blown? How about, like, when it makes the trees shake or your coat blow on a windy day, huh?
Rapture thrilled my heart, gone with
was a windy day. Talking about wind, though, we know that wind can blow sailboats.
Yep.
And we know it because you guys blew the sails and it went over, right? Moved one side, the other, did all that, right? Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. You want to find out another way?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Come here. Show you something else. Sit up here for a minute. Okay, now I'll tell you what. I have in my hand three balloons. I'll take the green balloon. I'll give you the red one, Jay.
Okay.
And if you pass this down to Ford, you'll have the orange one, okay? I would like you to blow the balloons up. Are you ready?
Yes.
You are?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Let's blow. Okay. Now let's hold them up here and see what you have. Okay, now Ford, you have a big balloon. And Jay, yours is a little bigger. Well, if you look over here, you'll see that mine is the biggest, right?
Yep.
Okay, so we have big, bigger, and biggest.
Big, bigger, biggest.
This is a big car, but what you need is a bigger car. I told you before, this car's not big enough for you. What you need is a bigger car. This is a bigger car. I have something a little better to show you. This is the car for you. It's the biggest car in the lot. Before, you don't want this car. This is the biggest car in the lot. I have something else to show you. But let us see.
Oh, it is too big.
Fine, let me show you another one. You don't want this car. This car is bigger than the car you need.
I want to see it anyway.
See, I told you it was bigger than you need. This is the car for you. This is a big car, but not too big.
Oh, it's beautiful.
I like it. We'll take it. It's great.
Wait, how much is it?
Oh, it's just a mere 12 and a half.
That's fine. And you know, this car is big enough.
I'm sure you'll be satisfied.
Biggest.
Bigger?
Big.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey, how'd you like to play a little game with Tracy and Leslie and me, huh? We have some things on the steps here that we'd like you to take a look at. Okay, look closely now, because it's one of these things doesn't belong here. Three of these things belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same. But one of these things just doesn't belong here. And now it's time to play our game. Time to play our game. Okay, look closely now at all these things. Can you guess which thing just doesn't belong? By the time I finish my song, gonna finish my song. One of these things just doesn't belong here. Tell me, did you guess which one? Well, if you guessed that this thing doesn't belong here, you're right. Oh, you're absolutely right. And now my song is done. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Now, you know why you're right? Because all of these things here are musical instruments, right? They're used to make musical sounds. The ukulele and the old snare drum and the trumpet. But this is a cushion, right? That's something you use to sit on, like this. Ah. Hey, come on down. You know, as long as we've got all of these people here and all these instruments, why don't we start a little band, okay? Tracy, you play snare drum, and you play ukulele, and I'll play trumpet. Let's see what sort of sounds these things make, okay? A one, a two, a three.
What things make sounds?
Many things make sounds.
What are those sounds?
Birds singing.
That's a big bird.
That's a rooster. He crows. Those are sheep.
Those two?
They're baby sheep, lambs.
Maybe they're Lewis. No, they're not.
That's a cow. Cows moo. Ducks quack. Geese honk. Hens cluck.
I know those sounds.
Those are breakfast sounds.
Why doesn't the dog bark?
You can't bark with your mouth full.
Walking makes a sound. And cars make sound.
That's not a car, that's a truck.
That's a car.
Those are machines that make roads. They make big sounds.
They're big machines, silly.
Little machines can make big sounds, too. Like a chainsaw.
Airplanes make kind of whistle sounds.
The city has many sounds.
A horse. A policeman and his whistle.
And lots of traffic.
A wristwatch. An elevator. Footsteps inside sound different.
An office has lots of sounds. Adding machines, staplers, typewriters. I hear those sounds a lot.
Why is it so quiet?
I don't know.
An explosion.
Thunder and rain.
The wind.
Running streams.
Many sounds. Is silence a sound?
I don't know.
Neither do I.
Well, Steve, I'd like to hear some sounds right now. We've got something right here that's going to make that pretty easy. It's called a radio.
Can you name this letter? If you said R, you were correct. Let's say R together now. Ready? R! Fine. Now, here's something that starts with the letter R. Do you know what this is? Here, let me help you to guess. Yes, it's a radio. That's a nice tune. My ship has sails that are...
It's a radio. Radio makes sounds, you know. And radio also begins with the letter R. Yeah. Since the letter R is one of the letters on Sesame Street today, the Steve, let's see if you can make an R, okay? A capital R, big one. That's pretty good. It's all right. How about a small R? Good. It's another good one. Let's see. It's a capital R and a small R, but they're both R's.
Today, I'm going to tell you about the letter R. R is for rooster and rubber and rake. It's also for river, and make no mistake, it's even for rowboat and rocks and for rain that causes the robber to go down the drain. Very well, what letter have we learned about today? R. Good heavens, a talking dog.
Hi, Ernie.
Hey, Bert.
What's new?
Nothing.
Huh? Hey, no, that's not true. You know, you've been down at the zoo all day now. Something must have happened there. Something happens there every day.
No, huh? No. Nothing happened there today. No? Nothing. No, not today.
Huh.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got a teeny-weeny scrape on my finger here. Teeny-weeny scrape, see?
Well, there. Now, you see, something did happen. Now, Ernie, tell me. How did you get that scrape there?
Yeah, I must have gotten it when I fell down.
Oh?
Yeah, I think that was it.
Well, how'd you fall down?
Well, let's see. That must have happened when I was running away from the dog.
Yep. Oh, the dog?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, why was the dog chasing you?
Well, he wasn't chasing me. See, I thought he was, but he was just running away from the tiger.
Oh. The tiger? Well, what was the tiger running around loose for?
Well, the monkey opened his cage by mistake.
The monkey? Oh, how did the monkey get loose, for heaven's sake?
Well, that's easy. See, he got out when I was trying to put the rabbit in his cage.
Now, hold it. Now, wait a minute. Now, wait. Why are we trying to put a rabbit in the monkey's cage?
Well, with all the elephants running around loose, I didn't want him to get stepped on.
The elephants? Sure. What were elephants doing loose?
Well, the hippopotamus was loose. Why not the elephants?
The hippopotamus? Now, all right, Ernie. All right. Now, how did the hippopotamuses get loose?
Well, I didn't see it. But I think it must have happened when the bus crashed into his cage.
The bus crashed? Well, how did that happen?
The bus driver couldn't see because of the bright lights.
The bright lights?
From the flying saucer.
The flying saucer? Now look, you were saying a minute ago that nothing happened to you today.
Well, I was wrong, Bert.
I should hope so.
Yeah, I got a teeny-weeny scrape on this finger. See?
Hey, Steve, you hear that?
Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds like an airplane out there. Maybe it's our skywriting friend. We'll go out and see?
Okay.
All right, come on, let's go. Yeah, that's who it is. That's who it is. He's out there writing another letter. Now, what do you think it's going to be? Oh, it could be a lot of things. It's coming around here like a... What do you think it might be?
A Q.
A Q? Well, that's possible. Or it could be making a C or a G. Now, let's watch it and see whether it links up there and makes the letter O, or whether it's a C, or whether... It can't be a C anymore, it can't be a G. Oh, it's the letter O.
Oh. Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh!
Grow and go, roll over the road where the goat explodes all the O's and the crow flies low. Past the croaking toad and the boat floats over the ocean, but the wind did blow and it started to snow. So the toad went home to the telephone. He spoke to the goat who was eating a bowl of bones, potatoes and soap. A rope did float and hooked the goat, and a boy climbed the stone made of O's. The O's turned to smoke and started to float closer to the bulldozer who closed up the holes. world would know that the boat bulldozer, the toad and the crow, the boy and the rope, riding the goat, we're all okay. Okay?
Seven spooky spiders.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Seven nickels.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Seven pumpkin pies.
Once there was a very jazzy triangle who just loved to dance. As you can see, a triangle has three sides. One, two, three. One day, the triangle met a very square square, who also loved to dance in his own way.
Are you square? You don't move. You're always the same. All four sides the same length. One, two, three, four. All four corners square as a box. I have three sides, and I can make them as long or as short as I want. I can be tall and thin, or short and fat, depending on how I feel. I sure am glad I'm a triangle.
Well, it's true, I can't dance as well as you can, and my sides and corners are always the same. But I don't have to decide which side to make long and which short. And I never have to think about what shape I want to be. I like being a square.
Yeah, but wouldn't you like to be able to move around as you please, like me, and change your shape any time you feel like it? Like this?
When you're a square, and that's that. Nothing personal. You like being a triangle. I like being a square. Everyone can't be the same. Well, so long. Nice talking to you. The triangle watched him go.
Not a bad guy,
he thought.
For a square.
And he danced all the way home.
Thank you.
Quail.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Flying things.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 cats.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 cameras.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 strawberry shortcakes.
Hello there. Hey, does anybody have a 2.5-month-old baby in your house? Well, we have one right here today on Sesame Street, a 2.5-month-old ocelot. Can you say hello, ocelot? Whoa, want to play hide under the arm, huh? There. Isn't she beautiful? Would you like to have one of these for a pet, Leslie?
Maybe if it's trained.
Yeah, well, these, they look very much like a regular little house kitten right now, but they really are a jungle animal rather than a house kitten, rather than a house pet like this one, aren't you? And you know how big they get? When they grow up, they'll be about twice the size of a big full-grown cat. That's about how big they get. And they live mostly in the jungles and in the tropics, places where it's nice and warm. And they hunt their food up in trees. And he's purring now like a little baby kitten.
So cute.
Isn't he? They have these protective spots all over them, brown and black spots, so that they blend right in with the jungle or with the rocks, places where they live. Helps protect them from other animals when they're little like this. Can you say ocelot? That's kind of a hard word to say, isn't it?
Ocelot.
Ocelot, right. Do you know a lot about an ocelot?
No.
You know, behind their ears, they have two little white spots. I don't know if you can see them or not, if I can get them to turn around here. They have two little white spots, and some people think that maybe they're there. They act sort of like eyes. They look like eyes, so that always looks like they're looking at someone. Well, listen, we've had groundhogs here today, and we've had ocelots, but you know what? It's time to go again. But I tell you what, you come back and see us again, okay? Because we're always here, and we love to have you around. So drop in and see us again. Say goodbye, ocelot. Say it again. Have you ever seen so many people on Sesame Street? Hi, Robin. How are you? Want to say hello to the ocelot, Robin? Isn't he soft and furry? Hear him purring? Hungry. I think you better not, because you have to be kind of careful, because it is a... It's kind of a wild animal, and they have very, very sharp teeth. Would you like to have a baby ocelot at home, Robin? Would you? Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters J, O, and R, and by the numbers 6 and 7. Mm-hmm. Sesame Street's a production of the Children's Television Workshop.